your boy, E.T. This is your opportunity. This is your moment. All right, guys. We're going to do something a little different than what we did the last time. I just want to kind of speak to you guys, and then we're going to do our interview. So I don't have a whole lot of time, so I just want to do 3 points, all right? So the first thing I want to tell you guys, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, the universe is yours, all right? And you need to understand that, that the universe is yours, that there are absolutely no limits, all right? And I want to, before I do ET and get excited, all right, you really need to understand that where you're sitting right now and the opportunity that you have, right, with this company, you need to understand that whatever it is you can imagine, whatever you could see, or perhaps you've seen somebody else do it, I honestly want you to know that there is no real secret to success. I know I say that a lot, the secret to success, right? But it's really, really not a secret, all right? And especially for you guys, it's not a secret because you probably know somebody in the company, right? And more importantly, you guys are in this room today, all right? So I just want to make sure you understand that literally the universe is yours. Now, this is critical. Why is this one state? Like, Eric, you could have started anyway. Like, you could have started with, you got one of these bags you want to breathe. Like, why did you start there? I started there because if you have, whatever it is you want to accomplish or whatever it is you want to do, you literally have to see it first, right? It doesn't start until you can visualize it. And once you can see it, like, you're off to the races. And that's why you have some people who are not here. I mean, honestly, you have some people who are not here who are not going to get this opportunity, right? Look, so let me say this. All right, so you guys know I'm all over the place doing all kind of work. But I can honestly say, as it relates to Verve, that this is probably one of the first companies I've ever worked with in my entire life that has nothing but you. Like, this is an incredible opportunity. And I don't know if you guys understand the energy that's associated with young people. And, like, for real, there are absolutely no limits. Now, when you're 42 years old, you got a different, like, your whole different perspective. You're worried about kids going to college. Like, you got a lot of limitations, right? You're worried about bills, insurance, like, right? You're worried about a whole lot of stuff, which actually, guys, whether you know it or not, which really stops certain people from being successful because they have so many barriers, so many obstacles to overcome that they never really get to success. You guys are starting without a whole lot of overhead. That's the greatest way to start a company, right? You have absolutely no overhead you're dealing with right now. So when I say the universe is yours, what I mean is the only part of the universe is yours is the part that you can see, all right? So whatever part of the universe you can see, that belongs to you. But if you can't see it, so again, there's a group out there like, we can't be done. This is a scheme. It's a scam. Let me tell you something. Walmart is a scam, all right? Walmart is a scam. Ford Motor Company is a scam. GM is a scam. Like, this is America. People have a product. They sell the product. You do business. Like, that's America. That's how it works, all right? So listen to me very closely. They are not in here, and they are not taking advantage of this great opportunity because they can't see it. Either they can't see it, or at some point they thought they saw it and they let somebody talk them out of seeing it, all right? One of the two. Just in case he's telling the truth, and I'm not 100% sure because I'm not really a stats guy, so I'm not 100% sure. But Malcolm Gladwell says it takes 10,000 hours to be, like, massively successful. He might be telling the truth. I'm not 100% sure, but it took me a long time. It might have been 10,000 hours, right? But you know what happened, guys? The reason why it took me so long in my 30s, you know, my late 30s, I'm 42. The reason why it took me so long to get the success I currently have is because I didn't start at 17 years old. Like, I didn't have a company say to me, Eric, at 14 years old, you can get started with the rest of your life. Here's a great product. Here's a great opportunity. Go for it. I wasn't 17. I wasn't 20. I grew up in Detroit. Like, the only opportunities in Detroit when I was growing up was Ford, GM, and Chrysler. Like, that, you work for the plant. With this business, you don't have to clock in and clock, like, 8 to 8. You don't have to clock in. Like, it's your time. It's your product. It's your opportunity. You can do whatever you want, however you want to do it. All right? So your age is important because you guys get an opportunity to start as early as you want to, and you can go for as long as you want to. And that's critical. Okay, 65-year-old lady blew my mind. My demographics is crazy, right? All right, when I read my stuff online, I'm like, unbelievable. She's 65 years old. She said, I just watch when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe. I'm thinking, you 65 when you watch that? Right? She's like, just about 30 days ago, I watched it, and I'm not a victim anymore. I'm starting my own business. I said, wow, at 65? I'm thinking that might be a little late in the game. Right? But I'm not upset with her. She's inspired, right? And so, but I'm thinking, like, wow, it took all 65. 65. She may have a good, and I don't want to jinx the lady. She could have a good 20 left. I don't know. 85, a good 25 left. I'm not 100% sure, right? But what I am saying is that she didn't start until she was 65 years old. She wasn't given this opportunity. She didn't know. 40 years ago, this opportunity wasn't, it didn't exist. So one of the things, guys, I want you to be excited about, but be careful. You are young, but you have, listen to me. The principles that I'm going to talk about that apply to success, you don't get to get away with murder, or you don't get a pass because you're 17. You don't get a pass because you're 18. You have a great opportunity, right? And I don't want you to be upset a year from now and say, why didn't I make the money Sarah made? Because you didn't do what Sarah did, okay? Bottom line, there's some things she did that you didn't do. You didn't do what Luke did, right? You were excited, you were pumped up, you were motivated, you took the initial step, you got in, you didn't just talk about it, because most people get stuck because they just talk. You didn't talk about it. At a young age, you were part of a great company and you're in an industry that you own because you made a decision. That's number one. You made a choice, right? And you ought to be commended, applauded for that. But now we're going to move forward, all right? So I told you, number one, you have to see it. And when I say see it, guys, you have to do me a favor. Like, you just don't see it on Monday. You have to see it Monday. You have to look at it again on Tuesday. You had to see it Wednesday. Look, I've been here before, but on the plane, believe it or not, I spoke to you already. Like, I already had my 20 minutes lined up. Like, all right, got it. Like, I was literally standing in front of you speaking. I was literally in front of you thinking about exactly what I was going to say. So when I got here and I had this great opportunity, right, to inspire you to greatness and to take this company to a level that honestly, you can take it to a level that BK couldn't imagine, right? You could take it there, guys. Like, for real, he's got a vision, but you could, like, with 30, 40 people in the room, you could blow his vision out of the water, right? Are you hearing what I'm saying? So the first thing I want you guys to do is see it every day. Now, this is important. The reason why I say you have to see it on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, right? Because some day isn't a day, right? Just in case you didn't catch that. Like, some day is not a day, right? I'm going to do it someday. Like, that's not a day. I hate to disappoint you. Right, I really do. I hate to disappoint you because some of you are there like, Eric, I'm gonna be great someday. I'm gonna take this company to that someday. No, you have to do it either on Monday or on Tuesday, right? Or maybe Wednesday, all right, or Thursday, right? Or maybe Friday, or maybe all of those days, including Saturday and Sunday, because someday does not exist. So the first thing I need you to do for me, guys, listen to me, you gotta see it. And once you can see it, believe it or not, you know my story. I was homeless. I'm not making it up. I was a high school dropout. I was eating out of garbage cans. And everybody always asked me, Eric, just like BK took this thing and took it to a whole other level because he could see it. Listen to me. Okay, maybe you didn't hear what I said. When I say see it, I mean before it even happens. That's what the greats do. Like, they see it before it happens, and then they actually get up every day and create it. So they see it first, they wake up, and then they spend Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday actually making that vision become a reality when there was nothing there in the beginning. So that's the first thing that happened for Eric Thomas. I woke up one day and said, I can't keep living like this. Like, I wasn't meant to live like this. Like, for real, for some of you, you weren't meant to live. Your parents are in some crazy situation, and by you becoming a multimillionaire, you're going to do a whole lot for your family, a lot for your community. Why? Because they don't deserve to live like that. Right? They don't deserve to live like that. And so your Monday, your Tuesday, your Wednesday, your Thursday is going to make a difference in their lives. All right? So first, you have to see it, and the only thing you need to see it is your imagination. You don't need anything else. Like, you don't need money. That's the beautiful thing. For when I was homeless, they didn't say, Eric, we need $1,000 down payment on vision. Before you can have a vision, we need a down payment of $1,500. Like, I didn't need any tools. I didn't need a college degree. Are you hearing me? I didn't need a college degree. Apparently, I didn't need a high school degree because I didn't have one. But you know what I had? I had a vision. Can I tell you something? When I told the world, and when I say world, I mean the people that were in my world, that I was going to be doing this one day, they told me, you crazy. Like, listen to me. When I tell people now I'm going to win a Nobel Peace Prize, you'd be shocked. They still don't believe me. I'm like, after all this stuff I said I was going to do that I did, like, you can't believe that? Like you shouldn't have believed that I was going to get here in the first place. Now you got to believe everything else I say from this point forth. So they didn't believe I was going to be standing here. But you know what I love about success? Only one person needs to believe. That's the thing I love about success. It doesn't take 10 or 20 people to believe. It actually takes one person to believe in. Who is that person? That's not the guy who's looking out at, you know, you don't have to look out the window. Okay, so write this one down because this is important. All right? Success does not require you to look out the window. It only requires that you look in the mirror. All right? I want you to put that down somewhere, right? BK can have that next week, all right? Put that down. Listen to me. To be successful, you don't have to look out the window and, oh, where's my help? Where are the people that I need? All you got to do is stop, look directly in the mirror, and the one person you need to blow up, the one person you need to be successful is looking right back at you. And if you're willing to make a commitment to that person in the mirror, if you're willing to look at that person in the mirror and say, I make a commitment to you from this day forward that whatever it takes, I'll do whatever it takes legally. You guys are in a great company. No, I didn't really have to say that because you got, it's a great company. It's legal. Everything's legal, right? Right. But I just wanted the disclaimer, all right? So I want you guys to look in the mirror if you haven't done it yet. I want you to tell the person in the mirror, this is where we're going to be a year from now, 2 years from now, three. Just look at the person in the mirror and say, get ready. Right? Guys, if you could see it and you could make a commitment to yourself. So I said, I know this may sound weird to you guys, but I love Michigan. I just don't like Michigan, December, January. I can't explain it to you, but it's a different city. December, January, February, March, April, and sometimes May. And so one day I woke up and said, you know what? Why can't I live in Michigan when it's warm? Why can't I live in Miami when it's winter? Why can't I? So I just made up a dream. Like, guys, I'm going to own homes in different spots. And I was on a plane the other day, and the airline stewardess said to me, oh, yeah, I live in the Bronx, and I own a home in Atlanta. I'm like, wow, I'm not the only one. She's actually doing it, right? All right, so the first one, guys, we're going to see it, and we're going to, whatever that means to you, if that's on your iPhone, if you're putting it up on the wall, right? You just, whatever it is, I think I see, becomes a verb to me, all right? So it's everywhere. I love it. What's your name, young man? Chase, when we dropped, somebody dropped the verb. They dropped the verb and the juice was all over the place, right? And Chase said, oh, it's like gold. Chase was like, it's like gold spilling. I was like, I like that, Chase. I like that. That's a different way of seeing things, all right? And so I want you to see it. I want you to see not just you making money, guys, because let me tell you something. If you follow the blueprint, if you follow the philosophy, if you stay with the mission statement, money is the least of your concerns, all right? That's the least of your concerns. If you follow the guru, right? And I know on YouTube I'm the guru, but not in this room, I'm not the guru, all right? Point to the guru, guys. All right, that's the guru. So all you have to do is follow the leader, right? And whatever it is you guys see, you can have. All right, so that's number one. All right, so I kind of alluded to number two, and when we talked about some kind of way in there is the haters. I don't know if you heard that. But some kind of way like inside there. I don't even like to say their names, really. I would give them too much credit, all right? But do me a huge favor, guys. Do me a huge favor. Don't totally dismiss your haters, all right? You want to use them as fuel, okay? Because the one thing I love about my haters that I don't like about my mom, my haters, they say some things my mom won't. She loves me. So there's certain things she's not going to say. So there's certain buttons mom don't even push. But the haters, I'm like, thank you. Let me write that down. Right? It's real. You guys are young. But I had an individual that tried to sabotage me. The greatest feeling in the world. About 4 years, he tried to sabotage me. Just try to tear down my character, tear down the company, just destroy me as a human being, and just tear my company up. Great thing happened the other day. Just great. I don't know how it happened, but I was in the same place this person happened to be in. It was weird. Right? And I'll be honest with you. I haven't seen the person in at least 2 or 3 years, right? We happened to be in the same convenience store. And I don't know what happened, but I had my head down, and I was walking in, and we literally bumped into each other. Like, I literally didn't even see the person walking toward me. We kind of bumped into each other, and as I was saying I was sorry, I looked and noticed the person. And without even knowing it, I did what Eric Thomas does. I'm a lover. So I hugged the guy and was like, man, how you doing? And the greatest feeling in the world were the words he said to me when he hugged me. He said, man, I'm doing good. Man, I'm seeing you everywhere. You all over the place. I said, I am. I am. Right? In the back, I didn't say it out loud, guys. I kept it to myself. But in the back of my mind, I said, you did not break me. Wow. And now you got to watch me on YouTube every day. Right? You got to see me, right? Because they're in the sports industry. Trust me. If you're in the sports industry, you got to see me. You got to hear me. And when I saw him for that moment, I was like, thank you so much. Thank you. Because you said some words to me that I wrote down and I put in my heart. And I had to make sure that the next time I saw you, that you knew you were a liar. So do me a favor. Don't take the hating and you take it all personal. She hates me. Don't take it personal, right? What I want you to do is write it down. I want you to use it for fuel. So when they say, all right, this company is a scam, what I want you to do is operate in integrity to prove them wrong. Now, hear what I just said. If they say you're a scam, this is not real, this is fake, then what you have to do is get up on Monday morning and prove that it's real. But you got to make money so you can show that it's real. Like, real, that's one of the ways you show people that you're real, right? Is to have a check. Right? Because I remember when I first started doing it, I'll be honest, even my wife was like, you quitting your job at Michigan State? Like, yeah, I'm quitting my job at Michigan State. But we have 401k. We have insurance. The kids' teeth will never be fixed again if you leave this job, right? We'll never have life insurance. It's all at Michigan State University. Like, right? Like, that's what she thought. Like, all the success in the world was right there at Michigan State. Let me just say this, and I don't say this to brag. But what it took me a year to make at Michigan State, I make in a month. And watch this. She didn't really believe at first, but it's something about the increase in the bank account that will make you a believer. Right? For real, when your whole student loan, like, for real, it takes people years and years and years to pay the student loan. When you can just go pay the student loan off, I don't worry about that. I got that. Bah! They start saying, I can see what you see now. Right? The vision becomes clear, right? So do me a huge favor, guys. Your haters, I want, if you're going to do business, if you're going to be successful, right? If you're going to make impact in the world, if you're going to celebrate life, you're going to have haters. Welcome to the real world. And so every hater you get, and the more intense they are, that is an indicator that you're on the road to success. Listen to me, broke people don't have haters. And if they do, it's like one or two of them. And they got them when they were in high school or something, or college, right? They made an enemy in college, right? So, again, number one, I want you to see it. Number two, listen to me, don't worry about the haters. Prove them wrong, but the only way you can prove them wrong is by doing the opposite of what they said about you, all right? So that's important. So if mom said, this is a great company, but you're lazy, you'll never do anything with your life, then you got to get up and prove mom you're, like you don't, listen, okay, so here's another one. Stephen Covey. You can't talk yourself out of something you behave yourself into, all right? So that's number three. I need your behavior. You got to change your behavior. I remember wanting to be a millionaire. I talked about it all the time. I want to be a millionaire, and it never happened. And I was like, it's not fair. I'm not a millionaire. I was born in Detroit. My father wasn't in my life. I was a victim. I had all of this stuff. And then one day I read that and said, yo, Eric, you need to change your behavior. Like, how are you going to be a millionaire and you don't have an account? Like, your business isn't registered. Like, you don't have a website. Like, what are you going to do with the millions? Like, put it in the basement? Like, right? And then I remember when I was making decent money in the beginning, I wasn't paying taxes. At the end of the year, I would pay it. And so they would get me at the end of the year. They would let me have it. Like, 40%, 45%, they let me have it. And so the reason why I couldn't be a millionaire at that time was because I didn't have my stuff in order. I didn't have an accountant. And so there's a certain behavior, listen to me, you can't motivate your way into taking this company to the next level, but you can behave, listen to me, although you can't talk yourself into something that you behave yourself into, you can behave yourself out of something you behave yourself into. And so what I need you to understand for me, if you're going to be successful, your Monday has to look a certain way, Tuesday has to look a certain way. Eric, are you taking away all the fun? No. When you're successful, you have more fun. Let me explain. I'm having a lot more fun now than I had when I had to go to White Castle's for burgers, right? There's a different Red Robins now, guys. I stepped it up. I stepped it up, right? I went from White Castle to a little smaller. Red Robins, all bottomless fries, guys. Bottomless fries. What a life it is, right? So I had to behave differently. And if you look at my schedule, I'm getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning now, right? And I have to be where I am. Somebody else may be able to get up at 5 or 6. It's not saying you have to get up at 3, but you have to know your schedule, your life, and what you need to accomplish. Perhaps the people you're talking to, they don't go to bed at 3 o'clock in the morning. So you got to stay up to 3 to get to those people, then you go to bed at 3. I'm not suggesting you do what I do, but I'm telling you, there's a certain way I had to behave to get what I wanted, and it wasn't just talking. So what I need you guys to do for me, all right? This is how you do it. I want you to model the people who are great. And you know what? Here's the craziest thing. They're sitting right here in this room. And they can give you the secret to success. They can give you the blueprint. And all you have to do is just follow it. Read a book the other day that changed my life, The Speed of Trust. There's a billionaire that I work with. And I asked the billionaire, I asked him a question. I said, look, guys, you know, you would think I'm in this room with this billionaire. You would think I would ask for money. I didn't ask for money. I wasn't interested. Money, I don't need, you got money, I don't need, I can get money, you got money. Didn't ask for that. Didn't ask to go on a vacation with him, right? You know what I asked him for? What I need to know, what book are you reading right now? Not the book you read 5, 10 years ago when you were trying to be successful, like you're a billionaire. Like what's attractive to you as a billionaire right now? And he gave me the book, read the book, changed my life, gave it to my staff, changed my life. What I need you to do for me, guys, before you go out here and try to change the world, learn it first. Be a lot easier, guys. For real, take it for somebody who learned, they call it on-the-job training, right? I was going in circles, guys, but when I hooked up with people like BK and such, you ask different questions. You put yourself in a different situation. So do me a favor. There are people in this room, and before you let them go, you need to get the blueprint. Write every single thing down. Remember what I told you, the universe is yours, but only the part of the universe that you can see. So number 3, you're going to change your behavior. You're going to do what successful people do. And the more often you do it, the more successful you're going to be. If you just do it on Mondays, then you'll be very successful on Mondays, right? But if you do it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, you got a better shot. But if you do it 7 days a week, so what I discovered, guys, that if what I say and what I do are congruent, then I have a better chance of being successful. It's the craziest thing. It's the craziest thing. I learned that, Eric, if you say this and you do it, wow, success. So I'm writing a book, a chapter for a book, and I was supposed to get it in. I don't know, a couple of days ago, I told a guy I'm going to be on a plane today. I'll get it done. I landed and said, I need to send it to my people so they can look at it, make sure I don't destroy the brand. But it's done, and I can send it to you, but you cannot publish it as is. But I want to send it to you because I told you when I got off the plane, I was going to send it to you. I'm off the plane, so I need to send it to you. Now, you can't use it as is, right? All right, might be some typos or something, but I wanted to keep my word. Listen to me, guys. If you do what you said you were going to do, that first moment when you got excited about this company, when you were fired up and you signed on the dotted line, right? And you were like, I'm committed. If you keep that and do that thing you said, because what's going to happen is between the time you said it and the time you're going to blow up, life is going to happen. Can I explain to you in college, I'm getting a PhD and some people died along the way. Auntie died on the way. Several aunts, actually. 3 aunts died from the time, well, actually 5 aunts died from the time I started college to where I am now. Guess what? The last thing my aunts would want me to do is say, I can't go to school. My aunts passed. I just can't. My aunts would want me to go to the funeral, celebrate their life, and get up and go back to school. Right? I've had a grandfather that died in the midst of my speaking career. My grandfather didn't want me to quit and give up on life. Can I explain something to you? The difference between average, right? And I'm allergic to average, may I remind you. I am. You might be all right with it, but I am allergic to average, right? I just can't really do. And I can't stand good. Like, I hate good more than I hate average, right? I hate good because good is a liar. Good perpetrates like it's great. So I got a real problem with good, a real serious problem with good. Can't stand average. Every time I get average, I just get like, I don't know, chicken pox or something like, ooh, average. How can they do that? Right? And there are people for average suits, they just average lives. I'm like, ooh, doesn't that get under your skin? And then those people who flaunt good as if it's great. So I can't stand it. But what I understand is that I say it, I do it, and life's gonna happen. But what I have to do is I have to match life for every trial. Guys, you are not going to just sign your name on the dotted line and boom, it's just gonna, 16 days from now, it's just gonna all land on it. No, you, it's here to be gotten. And that's why the stories we're gonna tell you today, that's why we're telling you the story so you can know. But look, some things in life, and I'm leaving you with this, some things in life you don't get, you gotta go take it. For real, it's some stuff that's happened for me. I got some retainers, guys. I didn't even know what a retainer was. Last year, the orthodontist, my son got dented, he got his braces. I thought that's what a retainer was. I didn't know. For real, because I paid. He lost it. I had to pay $350 for another retainer. I didn't know it was signing a contract with companies and working for them throughout the course of the year. I had multiple Fortune 500 companies that I'm working for. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But guess what? Some challenges happen, life happened, and some things I had to go take. I had to go take it, like, for real, guys. I was so accustomed to getting phone calls. Eric Thomas, can you speak here? Eric Thomas, can you speak there? The retainers didn't come from me sitting at home waiting on a phone call. The retainers came from me staying in contact with individuals, going to trainings that I wasn't getting paid for, picking up books and learning their philosophies. It didn't come to me like the other gigs came to me. Some things will come to you. There are those of you who are in this business because you met somebody that knew somebody or you had a good friend. That part came to you, but the success will not come to you. Some things you got to take by force or you'll never have them. They're not just, and nobody's going to knock. Federal Express, listen to me. You will not be a multimillionaire. Federal Express will knock on your door. Can you sign here, please? I have multi-millions for you. Just sign. That's it. Are you Eric Thomas? Yep. Just sign here, Mr. Thomas. Can we see some identification? Here it is. Yep. Here's your millions. No, but guess what? Even though they say we're in a recession, every time I go downtown Chicago, I don't see the recession. I see kids walking out with American dollars. American dollars cost a lot. I saw like one girl, like three, and then mom had like three girls, and they all had like two, three American dollars. I was counting 150, 200. Like, we're not in a recession anymore. They just got dials, right? I went to, what do they call it? What's the restaurant? Cheesecake Factory. Like, we had to wait for an hour. I'm like, I thought we were in a recession. I was just looking to walk right in and get at a table. It's five of us, all right? Just here's the table. There's like an hour, please. Listen to me, guys. Don't believe the hype. We're not in a recession. What has happened is the people who don't really want to work, they just don't have excess money for them anymore. The people who are not going to get up in the morning and grind, the people who are not going to do what they're supposed to do, you just can't live off of folks no more. But the people who are ready to work, it's still money to be made. It's still money to be had. But the people who are ready to grind and tell and to shut, kill the noise, all the haters, you just laser focus. No, for real, you got to get that in your, like you don't even hear them anymore. You just laser focus. So if you're ready, that the table has been set, guys. The table has been set. If you're ready to take advantage of an opportunity of a lifetime, it may not be given to you, but if you're ready to earn it, the universe is yours.